Nagy tisztelettel köszöntöm mindazokat, akik kivárták a délutáni kezdési időpontot. Egy icipici csúszásba kerültünk. Ennek nagyon prózai oka van. Technikailag ez az első alkalom, hogy a konferencián belül Skype-on fogunk egy kollégával beszélni, illetve Skype-on keresztül közvetítjük Bécsből az előadást. Az előadó Franz Josef Weber úr lesz, aki a Siemens Mobility GmbH-nak az igazgatója, és az új kerék- és tengelytechnológiák városi vasúti alkalmazásokhoz témában tartja meg előadását, amelyre fel is kérem őt.
Jó napot kívánok! Örülök a lehetőségre, hogy itt tudom beszélni önnek a új fejlesztésekről. Az utolsó mondat az előtti prezentáció volt, fejlesztésekre mindig lesz igény. És ma nekem van a lehetőséget, hogy tudom bemutatni kettő innovációk. A presentation I will make in English, it's easier for me. Oh, I apologize for this. I will present you two new technologies in wheels and axle applications for urban rail vehicles. I prepared the presentation together with Laszlo Boronkai and Martin Rieger from TU Graz. First of all, I want to say something about the Graz plant of Siemens. The Graz plant has a long tradition in railways and is today a Siemens center with a world competence. The tradition started in 1845 with Johann Weitzer, who founded a factory for coaches, what were driven by horses, and later on they started to make train coaches. Today the plant is a Siemens plant since 30 years, a Siemens plant. Siemens started to use their bogies for high-speed trains, for tramways, for locomotive, and the whole portfolio. On the next slide, I will show you some products. A lot of them you know about. You know the high-speed train and intercity trains. You know our commuter trains like Mireo, you know the metro trains we are producing, for example, for Warsaw and Vienna. We have tramways. We heard about tramways from Siemens some minutes ago. We have locomotive in our offer and pantographs as a specialty, pantographs for locomotives and other vehicles. So, to summarize this, you see all axle loads up to 30 tons, for example, for locomotives in the USA, and you see the whole speed range from tramways in urban applications and high-speed trains, the newest SF900 bogey for the Velaro Nuovo high-speed train, what will be offered in applications where we have really high speeds from about 400 kilometers an hour. The next slide will go a little deeper in the directions of innovation. What innovations we want to give our customers in the field of bogies. So we see one field, it's digitalization. we see the field of reduced energy consumption. So essential in this part is weight reduction. We see as an important thing the reduction of wheel and track wear. We see as a need of customer to have an extension of maintenance intervals. And we, to be competitive, want to be fast with our innovations on the market, and always the costs of our products are a topic as well. In these areas, we address so electronics and mechatronics. We address the production technologies. We address components and alternative materials. We address our engineering methods, and we address overall bogey concepts. I mentioned the Velaro Nova bogey as an example. I mentioned the bogey platform for Mireo. We are innovating in the field of production, especially specialized for automatized welding with double robot welding on complete bogey frames. So you need special machines to handle the bogey frame. We have a prototype running for a lightweight bogey frame in Austria with a high strength steel, what reduces the weight of bogey frame by over 30%, and we work on active steering. The two things I want to talk to you today are some component specific things. One thing is the deep rolling of wheels and axles to introduce compressive stresses in the axle and to increase the load capacity of the axle. And the other thing is the ADE spoke wheel, a cast wheel with spokes to reduce weight, noise, and wear. Why we want to have ADI wheels? What is ADI? ADI is a special ductile cast iron. There's a heat treatment, also tempered, and this heat treatment gives the material a special strength, what is comparable with forged iron or forged steel. However, it's a cast steel, and the cast steel or cast iron has a higher damping than the steel, so the wheel will be quieter. The wheel has, as a cast iron, a lower density than the traditional steel wheels, so we can reduce the weight of the wheel. And the material is really wear resistant. Sometimes the IDE material is called a wear material, and the wear between wheel and rail is an important point we want to reduce. Some general information about this material. So the material isn't really new, but it's new for this application. We compared the materials according European wheel standards, what have a high strength. They have a high compressive strength. And the wheel material, the classical wheel materials, has a high elongation as well. So for our application of the wheel, we have chosen the GJS 900 So ADI material, what is not so hard string wheel, but what has a good elongation as well. There are some previous work on this topic from the last 30 years. There were examples in Finland. The Finnish railway tested some wheels like this about 25 years ago. But they were not able to find manufacturers what can produce these wheels regularly. Other tests were done by the German railway. The German railway tested these kind of wheels on a test bench in Kirchmöser, where they test the behavior of the wheel rail contact, and they proved that both the wheel and the rail have less wear than a traditional combination from steel and steel. So the lubricating action of the graphite helped to reduce wear between wheel and rail. What does the wheel look like? We decided to work with a spoke wheel. Why we decided to use a spoke wheel? We said when we have we want to use a casted wheel, we want to have the advantage of the technology of casting. And casting gives you the possibility to have a shape what is free. A traditional wheel, a forged wheel, you have not the possibility to use all the space between axle and wheel rail contact. You have to have strongly restricted situations because of fabrication technologies. In the casted wheel, you can use different shapes, and you see some optimization steps we have done. And at the end, we are inspired by a tree, the casted wheel of our design. Similar to a tree, so you have a lot of connections between the wheel tread and the axle, what gives us safety. If one spoke will broke, it will be broken, what we do not expect, but when it would be, then the wheel is still running well. We started to test this wheel in Nuremberg, German town, the metro system, they have vehicles from Siemens, and we tested 1 year ago for 3 months the wheels, and we will start again field test with this wheel and beginning of next year, and we will test the large amount of wheel as well. Yes, the fatigue test has been done for these kind of wheels. We have made two types of wheel testing. One testing was done at single test bench in Clausthal Zellerfeld, where we have tested four wheels. And what really was impressive, we have tested one wheel until two spokes were broken. So we overloaded the wheel and we could count the spokes what were broken. And even with 12 spokes broken, the function of the wheel, the function to transmit forces from rail to rail was still in work. This demonstrates the safety of this type of wheels. The next text of the next slide, we will demonstrate the next test we have done in Graz, we have a sinus jet test bench for wheels. This is a test bench what uses especially the resonance effect of an axle. So we have a rotating bending machine with a high test frequency of 41 hertz. And there we have made some additional tests with this wheel that you can see on the right side, a lot of measurement points we have on the wheel, and all these spokes we're running here, there we are making their fatigue strength tests according to the standards for wheels, and we do 10 million load cycles to qualify a wheel. So to summarize these things, we have a basic technology where we have investigated the material, the casting and the heat treatment. We have made a lot of FEM calculations to optimize the design. We have made test benches and test bench fatigue tests, and we test the wheels in regular service. The tests in regular service helps us as well to underline the possibilities of homologate and get acceptance from state for this new type of wheel. This was the one innovation, quite new, ID spoke wheel. Then we come to the other thing, the deep rolling of axles. The deep rolling we have investigated at wheels and at axles. And the application we are doing today is the deep rolling of axles. You can here see a tool working on an axle to improve the quality of the surface and to improve the material near the surface. The motivation is clear. There are examples of broken axles. Don't hesitate, do not feel. On the next slide, we have underlined the axle itself. They are very, very safe. When we go on the next slide, we can see the number of broken axles in Europe. And there have been a reduction, an enormous reduction of broken axles and broken wheels. These kind of precursors of accidents are in Europe really rare. That's very good from technical point of view, but we have one problem. We cannot use new technologies because we cannot see how long inspection interval must be. The traditional way to define inspection intervals is to count mistakes, and then you know between a crack and an accident you have a certain time. But when we do not have any accident, and if we do not find any cracks, we cannot say if the inspection strategy is okay or not, and so innovation is not possible. What to do to investigate this? We have to do research. And so Siemens supported research, especially in Germany, research to have a better understanding of the axles. There were three projects to develop these new methods. In the first one, the question was mainly on fatigue. In the second one, we have investigated crack propagation. And in the third project, we have investigated crack propagation in a deeper way. We made a lot of test bench investigations. We were 35 axles were destroyed to see how fast the cracks are going in the material. And there we have found one important thing. On the next slide, I will explain the effects, what effects we have in an axle to influence the crack propagation. We have one effect of high loads. So if sometimes the high load is in the axle, it stops the propagation of a crack. We have a second influence, the influence of low loads. When you have long low loads, we have oxidation in the crack tip, in the crack end, and this stops as well the speed of crack propagation. Third point, we have internal loads, we have residual stresses. So residual stresses have an important influence on the crack propagation, and this point, residual stresses, we use when we introduce residual stresses by deep rolling. The fourth point cannot be used in reality. We have learned that a not operating time has a influence on the crack propagation, but this is not predictable as you do not know how long a train is standing. Sometimes it's standing for a month. If you have a wagon, sometimes it's going away quickly. By the application of deep rolling, by introducing stresses by deep rolling, we can increase the lifetime of an axle what has a crack. And the difference between the lifetime is large. A typical value we can achieve as 3 is 100% of additional lifetime. What means instead of inspecting an axle, for example, every 100,000 kilometer, you can extend an axle. You can extend the inspection interval until 300 kilometer, 300,000 kilometers. So in a urban application, that means you have to make an ultrasonic inspection instead of every year, only every third year. Yes. How to develop this technology? Of course, it's not enough to have only the information that it would help. It's important to have a technology what gives systematically the same values of deep rolling, the same values of residual stresses, the same value of dimensional change. When you deep roll, you have a dimensional change, especially in the seat, and this change is not allowed to be too large. So we have to develop a new manufacturing technology. The technology has to be qualified. It has to be qualified by tests. The tests are tests on the component, destructive tests, when we measure hardness, when we measure the residual stresses themselves. And we have to do tests by destroying axle similar to the research project. So we make tests in original dimensions with original crack, and we see how fast they are running. And with this knowledge, we are able to stretch the inspection intervals. this optimized spare part has a lot of advantages for the operator. You have an increased availability of the vehicles. You have a reduced probability of fail overall. We have an advantage as well in the press fits of the between wheels and axles, so you have lower quantity of axles you have to change after wheel change, and in some applications the possibility exists to reduce the axle weight because the fatigue of the axle itself has been increased. So thank you very much again for the possibility to present some results. We have shown two things, Fehlerstechnische Mindegles Igenre, as Voltak Kette Peldak is Hokerishek Vondak Sivashen Balasolok.